The Green Goblin is one of, if not the most, notorious villains of Spider-Man. If you already do not know him, here he is.
Strong enough to stab at all.
In the beginning of Spider-Man, No Way Home, the story continues from when Peter is exposed to be Spider-Man by Mysterio.
Spider-Man's name is Peter Parker!
What the f***?
He then visits Doctor Strange, who eventually ends up attempting to cast a spell, to make everyone forget that Peter is Spider-Man.
Nice knowing you, Spider-Man.
After this fails, people who are aware of the double life of Peter Parker and Spider-Man were brought to this universe, including his villains.
Hello, Peter.
But at what point were they brought to the universe of the MCU? And therefore, what happened once they returned? When the Green Goblin first makes his iconic entrance in No Way Home, we can first of all see that he has all of his armor on.
Osborn?
Clearly it is shiny and undamaged, therefore we can say with confidence that he arrived in this universe before his final fight with Spider-Man, in the abandoned hospital. Where he would eventually die.
Godspeed, Spider-Man.
Oh. This is because, at this time his armor is dirty and slightly damaged. Due to the nature of Doctor Strange's spell, we know that Osborn, or the Goblin, knows that Peter Parker is Spider-Man.
He knows who I am.
Therefore it must have happened after the Thanksgiving dinner in Spider-Man 1, where Osborn notices the scratch on Peter's arm, revealing to Norman that he is Spider-Man.
How did you say that happened?
Bike messenger. Knocked me down.
As the Goblin wounded Spider-Man in the exact same place. The next time that we see Norman in the Goblin suit is right after the famous scene of him crawling to the mask in desperation.
Tell me how!
The heart, Osborn. First, we attack his heart.
It is the moment where he attacks Aunt May. Which would then lead him to call Peter at the hospital.
Can Spider-Man come out to play?
This ignites their final battle. If the spell works so that the villains are sent back to their universe at the same point at which they left, we can assume that this would mean the Goblin would come back somewhere around this point. Before the final fight, and after the Thanksgiving dinner. This brings hope that there is a chance that Norman can still survive once he is back in his universe, because he is not too far gone to make amends with Peter. Of course, since he is cured however, the Goblin is all but destroyed, yet this does not mean that the armor would go to waste. Perhaps the people of Raimi's Spider-Man trilogy would see a new Goblin appear, a heroic Green Goblin, doing good alongside Spider-Man, alike the duo we see at the end of Spider-Man 3, with Harry as the Goblin teaming with Peter.
You came.
Although, this is unlikely, because even before the Thanksgiving dinner, once Norman figured out Peter was Spider-Man, he had already committed too many crimes to be easily forgiven by the people, let alone the law and authorities, such as killing the board members and destroying his business rivals.
Out, am I?
Because of this, it wouldn't be a surprise to see Norman Osborn go to prison, serving time for everything he has done. Everything the Green Goblin did. Maybe Norman would be okay with this, believing it is right, and that justice must be served. Or perhaps he would protest it, arguing that it was not him but it was the Green Goblin, who did all these terrible acts.
The goblin killed, I had nothing to do with it!
Regardless, I think it is safe to say that it may be the end for the Green Goblin as far as appearances on the big screen go, except for possible variants from other universes or even appearances from a previous point in our chronological timeline. This also doesn't necessarily mean that we won't see Norman Osborn again in the future.
You know, I'm something of a scientist myself.
We can only hope. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe.